करता हूँ
यार बिना चैन का रे।
वो लड़की थी कन्या, तुमने पुरुष से प्यार किया लड़के से।
विश्व हिंदू परिषद कॉल्स होमोसेक्सुअलिटी एन इम्पोर्टेड डिजीज। सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी क्लेम्स फाइटिंग फॉर LGBTQ प्लस राइट्स इज एन अमेरिकन गेम। The strongest opposition to decriminalizing homosexuality in India was on these grounds of it being against our Indian culture. But really? Let's rewind a little. Kama Sutra in the 4th century AD mentions physical pleasure in male-male unions in vivid detail. 14th century Bengal folklore tells the story of a sexual relationship between two widows. Bhakti saints in medieval India would effeminize themselves to worship Krishna and Shiva. Nawabs in the court of Awadh in the 18th century would dress up as women on certain holy days. Scholars point out that while these queer practices might not have been widely practiced norms, they were never derided or looked down upon. In fact, till the early 1800s, Indian poets like Insha and Rangin were openly writing about male-male and female-female relations in the same tones as heterosexual relationships. So, when did things change? Homosexuality began to be viewed as a crime against the order of nature only in 1860 when Thomas Macaulay introduced Section 377 into the Indian Penal Code, modelled after the English Buggery Act of 1533, which made anal and oral sex a punishable offence. Victorian sensibilities were aghast at texts like the Kama Sutra. In fact, India's openness towards sex and sexuality ironically became one of the reasons the British classified it as a backward civilization. In response, Indian nationalists asserted the respectability of Indian culture, in turn adopting conservative Victorian attitudes towards our own non-heteronormative traditions. By the 1920s, when Hindi writer Ugra published the short story collection Chocolate, it caused an uproar. Even though the book denounced homosexuality, journalists, writers, and reformers criticized the author for writing about homosexual desire, a subject they felt was not to be mentioned. By 1967, Britain passed a law legalizing same-sex relations, but the Victorian idea that homosexuality was unnatural had become entrenched as an integral part of Indian sanskar. In 1998, for instance, when Indo-Canadian filmmaker Deepa Mehta's lesbian love story Fire was released in Indian theatres, it led to large-scale protests by Indian political parties from Bajrang Dal to BJP, who attacked theatres and burnt effigies of the actors, accusing the film of being alien to Indian tradition and culture. But LGBTQ+ activists have fought back against these perceptions. They held counter-protests during the release of Fire. And it is their legal and social work over the years that highlighted our rich history of queer traditions and uniquely Indian experiences of queerness. This activism, combined with the courage of prominent LGBTQ individuals, paved the way for the long legal battle that led to the Supreme Court finally decriminalizing homosexuality in 2018. We, nonetheless, have a long, long way to go. A 2014 survey found that only 30% of people in India are broadly supportive of homosexuality. The country's ruling party maintained pin-drop silence on the landmark 2018 judgment, and forced conversion therapy by families is still a common practice in many parts of India. But queer activism is taking a range of different forms, speaking through cinema, politics, music, sports, and many different mediums to challenge the heteronormative idea of what constitutes Indian culture. Queerness is not against Indian culture. It's at the very core of it. Thank you for watching this video, and if you like Overthinking with us, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon here to stay updated.